Finalmente, en este segmento vamos a tener la entrevista con David Woodhouse, el nuevo jefe de diseño global de Lincoln Motor Company, la división de lujo de Ford, que visitó también Miami y estuvo en un panel sobre cómo es que se relaciona la arquitectura con el diseño de autos de lujo. Y para eso pueden visitar nuestra página en Facebook y en YouTube Autos Javier Mota para que vean los videos. Aquí está David Woodhouse de Lincoln en Miami.
Well, David, thank you for visiting us here in Miami, and I guess you escape the cold weather in Detroit, huh?
Yeah, it's a pleasure being here. It's actually first time in Miami.
Oh, really?
But yeah, as you know, the winter we've had has been really shocking. So myself and my wife, we landed the beginning of December. And just in time for all the bad weather. So actually being here now is awesome.
Yeah, actually, I think we got a break for the Detroit Auto Show because it was right, I think, before the big storm and then after the other one. So anyway, let's talk about cars now. I mean, sure. Because Lincoln, obviously, is in a revert process, let's say, right? It's been happening for a few years, but there's still a lot to come.
Yeah, I mean, I've actually been with the Lincoln team previously at Ford back in 1999 until about 2003-04. So I'm sort of coming back to the brand again. And, you know, I have an American wife. I've lived in California for 8 years. We've been back in London for 5 years. But coming back to the States again and coming back to this brand, you know, I'm just reminded again of like how much potential this brand has.
Yeah.
You know, I think it's one of the true great American iconic brands, and there's just so much we can do in the future, you know.
Yeah, and having been there before, I guess it's a huge advantage because you know exactly what you were saying, all the heritage, and maybe some people who are still there from those times, but also you bring in something from wherever you were before, right?
Yeah, I mean, experience in your life keeps growing, and obviously coming back, you know, after doing a lot of other things in the meantime, it's still with Ford Motor Company, but I can bring a lot more learning and experience to the job now, so it's really good.
Yeah. So the luxury segment, it's very, very challenging now. I mean, because especially this in the past few years in the auto shows, we've seen Maserati with a very not very expensive car and Kia with a very expensive car. They're basically the same price.
Yeah.
So, I mean, it's very, very competitive, that segment. People coming down, people coming up. So, and Lincoln is in the mix, obviously.
Yeah, absolutely. And, you know, again, I think that reinforces for me why having a historic brand, a brand that's known throughout America and actually known throughout the world, is really important because it provides the potential, it provides, you know, the character of what we can do in the future. So yes, you're right, very competitive you know, landscape out there at the moment, and you know, we're all trying to do something special. But I think, you know, it just tells me that the potential is there with Lincoln and we can do something amazing.
Yeah, for example, and some things that I think you're doing already amazingly is like, for example, offering the same car with a hybrid or a gasoline engine for the same price. I mean, just making the people decide.
Yes.
I think that's a good, that doesn't have to do much with design, but like as a whole brand and like an offer to the consumer, that's something really, really smart.
Yeah, yeah, customer choice is what it's all about, yeah.
And then also the whole experience has changed. I mean, not only like having a car and deciding I'm going to buy this car, but the whole experience of buying the car, like servicing the car, and all those things are really important nowadays.
Yeah, I think obviously with social networks and everything we've seen coming to the fore over the past sort of decade, I think we're in a time of sort of experimentation of the brands, of trying new ways of, you know, engaging with the customer. So I think it's a very exciting time. There's a lot of technology, lots of opportunity, lots of things we can do out there. And obviously, we want to orchestrate doing all the right things around what customers want for the future.
Yeah. And I know you're going to tell me much of what you're working on, but like, what can you tell me?
You know, I think we're at a really exciting, vibrant time for Lincoln. As you know, we've got lots of new product coming out at the moment. And some of those are really exciting products. You know, the MKZ, I think, is one of the most exciting cars out there on the market at the moment. And I think if you just look at what we've got and what's happening, and try and imagine, you know, where we can be in another 10 years, I think it's going to be pretty incredible.
Yeah, and that has changed also in the auto industry. It used to be like a prototype was like there at the auto show, and then it will pass like 5 years, and then it will come out maybe part of it. But now this prototype production, like production prototype, I think they call them now, right? I'm saying they're like really, really quickly.
Yeah, kind of like teasers, you know, to what's coming a year, literally like a year later. Yeah. So, I think concept cars, teaser concepts, there's a lot of action and a lot of motivation to generate new ideas for the brand.
Yeah. So I guess in New York is the next big auto show here in the States. We're going to see something from Lincoln there?
I'm not sure about New York. I think we've got other things happening at New York. But for sure, the auto shows that are rolling up very shortly, you'll be seeing more things from Lincoln, yeah.
Well, thank you very much for your time, and let's enjoy here the night in Miami. It's a beautiful night.
It really is beautiful, yeah.
Send a picture to your wife. If I get the time. Thank you, David.
You're welcome.
Este programa fue una producción de National Latino Broadcasting.